Yo, what's up everybody, and welcome back to the channel in another World of Tanks Blitz video. And this time I will be talking about this vehicle here, the PZ4S, or the Panzer 4S, a tier 6 premium medium German tank, is right now the main reward of this event, the luxury lounge event. We can got this tank, the PZ Schmalturm, whatever it's called. This is this tank, okay? And it's really pretty good one. Definitely it's a strong medium tank on stats. If we have a look, we got everything, really a solid DPM, a strong turret. We can do really crazy things with this vehicle, and that's what I'm going to show you in this video, to showcase you this tank, trying to show you how to drive it, what can we perform with this vehicle on the battlefield. So on stats, okay, we have here a tank, as I told you, with a high DPM, not the highest alpha damage, but for a medium tank, tier 6 medium tank, 160 is not bad at all. The strength of this vehicle is, of course, the TPM. That means the very fast reload time and the armor, especially the turret. We can really play hull down with this vehicle and block some damage. The speed is not the fastest. We got, for example, another like the Cromwell B, which is much more faster than this one. But in general, and on all, this tank is really pretty good, and we can really perform great battles with it. Especially, as I told you, we got a strong turret, we can block a lot of damage, and we got also a very nice gun depression, 10 degrees. Of course, we know 10 degrees in this game is really pretty good, and that means we can play hull down with this vehicle, especially if you are on high ground or in summit of hills. Just sneak, show only your turret, sneak your shot, then roll back, and you will definitely, block a lot of damage. That's how we're going to try to play with this vehicle. Of course, if your team is leading, if the situation will allow you to rush, to push, to use your high TPM, you can do it. So yeah, actually that's it. I will show you the equipment of this vehicle and then just jump straight to the battlefield. So the TPM is really insane, 2.2k of TPM. Let's compare it, for example, with other strong mediums in the game. We know them all. For example, the Cromwell B, which is insane, got only 2k TPM, okay? But the Cromwell got, for example, a better mobility. The Brittany Panther got 1.9. The STRV got how much here? Also 1.9, let's say 2k. So let's take also not only, premium tanks. This one, 2k DPM, the Cheeto. Okay, I don't know, let's take the VK30, for example, which is also known that is a strong vehicle, got only 1.9. So what I want to say is this tank belongs just to the best medium, tier 6 medium tanks in the game in point of DPM, and it's also in point of accuracy. If we have a look at the gun dispersion, we got here 0.269, which is insane. Supercharger, I will advise you to go for it, because we will also sometimes play from distance, play passive with this tank, and we will need the supercharger to do some long distance clean shots. Defense system, improved assembly. I mean, yes, we have a good turret, but if you go for enhanced armor, you are not going anywhere to maximize it, because the hull is easy to penetrate for anyone with or without enhanced armor. So go for improved assembly, enhanced racks, improved optics, engine accelerator, and the high-end consumables. I'm going provision for improved fuel and chocolate, and 2 repair kits and adrenaline. I will not go for engine power boost, because we still have a good mobility for this tank, and better to go for safety first and take two repair kits and adrenaline. So far so good. That's it on paper on stats for this vehicle. Really a strong tank, and we really can perform great battle with it. I will show you also some battles in this review. I will show you, of course, 2 victories, but I did also some battles where I lost, okay? But it's really because of my team. I did a lot of battles like this one, 2.3k of damage, second class mastery badge, even we lost the battle. And for example, now this one, also 2.4k of DPM, 655 damage block, and second class mastery badge. So if you have a bad team, you can do whatever you want. You can do the best battle ever and still lose. That was this battle here, a potential for an ace tank, a mastery badge, but we lost it because of my teammates. And yeah, it just happens. But in general, as we can see, a lot of green, a lot of battles won with this tank. And yeah, that's proof that this tank is really insane. And it's also, as we can see there, a very nice credit maker. So now, enough talking, let's jump to the battlefield and see what can we do here with this German beast on the battlefield. Here we go again. This battle is even against tier 7 tanks, okay, tier 7 and tier 6 vehicles. We've got 4 tier 7 tanks, Helsing, Magnat, Super Hellcat and VC-44, all of them really great vehicles, strong vehicles. So we have a strong enemy team here, and we manage already to sneak a shot and to block a lot of damage. And that's what I told you guys, it's a hull down beast, guys. Look at this, 10 degrees of gun depression. That means you can just go carefully up there, sneak your shot, then roll back, and with that the enemy will see only your turret, and you will have a high probability, as we can see there, to block a lot of damage. Of course, not every shot will bounce. There's still some good players there, or good tanks with good penetration. They will be able to penetrate you somehow, but we still can block a lot of damage even against tier 7 vehicles if you show only your turret. The Helsing, impossible to ban for me from this position, but I managed also to block some damage, and that's really pretty good. So now I'm getting pushed, and that's what you shouldn't know with this vehicle, to get pushed, okay? Especially in the beginning of the battle. And that's why I decided here to sneak another shot than to fall back. So now it's my part of the game to play passive, because I'm one shot, everybody can finish me, whatever, a tier 7 or a tier 6 vehicle. And then lately it's clever really to fall back and play passive, because if you stay there, expose yourself in the middle of the map, they will finish you. Let the heavies now do the job. The IS, for example, he still got a lot of hit points, and I will be waiting for that opportunity to help my team from distance and do some long distance shots. We got also the Super Hellcat, we got also who else, let's have a look. The Cryos, the IRL, they are all full HP, so don't be dumb at the situation because you are hungry for damage and keep pushing and dying very fast. Don't do that mistake. It's also very clever to know the situation and say, hey, I should stop now, I got also some teammates who can also take some damage for me. I fall back and I sneak from distance, and that's what I'm gonna do here. Here we go, another shot, and the finishing shot on that Titan 150 will come now. Boom, that was pretty risky, very risky, but somehow I finished him. So and that was, as we can see there, very clever to fall back and not do that mistake and push. And this is really an average battle. What we are going to do with this vehicle, what are we able to do? We are able to play Haldan, as we saw. We block in this battle a lot of damage, and also like the other battle that I showed you in the beginning of the video, it's a great vehicle. We can also spot damage assisted. We got here nearly 1k damage assisted. I dealt nearly 1.2k of damage, and I blocked a lot of damage with that, my third class mastery badge, and against tier 7 guys. That's really insane. This second battle, and the last for this video, for this showcase, for this review about the PZ4, and this time against tier 6 and tier 5 vehicles. That means it will be more easier for me. I will risk more because I can block more damage thanks to my armor. So it's a medium tank with a strong armor, and we can really rely on it, especially if you are playing against lower tier tanks and tier 6 vehicles. We can risk more, we can push more, because even the hull will be doing its job here and will also block the damage. As we saw there, I finished the STRV, even I was in front of him on flat ground, he didn't penetrate my armor. So against lower tier tanks, the frontal armor of this tank is really great. You can risk more. That doesn't mean that you are invincible, but yeah. Here we go, here we got the STRV 7482. I'm lucky to farm some damage, some free shots on that dude because he is AFK. I will take it, I will take it with me. Let's take that damage. Let's take that damage to get more credits in the end of the battle. We know all more damage means more credits. And boom, I will let my teammates finish him with that last shot. The S35TA will be also anyway finished soon, so let's keep pushing. We still have a lot of job to do here in this battle. We got plenty of heavies and TDs with full HP, so we still can go for more damage in this battle, and especially I'm full HP, so I can risk more right now. Let's finish first this Semovenzi M41 and then keep pushing. The Hellcat is also hungry for damage, pushing like that, and I will help him, of course, the Cheeto. So as we can see there, we got 4.4 seconds of reload time without adrenaline, and with adrenaline we have only 3.6 seconds of reload time. That means if you are pushing, this tank will be really a pure machine. I mean, 3.6 seconds of reload time using adrenaline, that's really insane, and that's really like, yeah. And non-stop shooting out to load a tank with only 3.6 seconds reload time in a matter of 20 seconds. That means you will be able to fire 5 shots, yeah, I think, yeah, or even 6 shots with adrenaline with that reload time. And that will be really very deadly in the end of the battle if you are pushing, if you are playing aggressive. So insane battle again. We got here 1.8k of damage. Also some damage blocked, 200 or let's say 300 of damage assisted, and we won also plenty of credits, and because I got, of course, a second class mastery badge, I got my ingot, I got my diamonds, by the way, we got right now this event, right? And yeah, I wish you all good luck to unlock this tank. It's really worth it to go for beginner players and also for skilled players. Yeah, it's an insane vehicle for beginner players because we got some armor on this vehicle. Beginner players have always problems to deal or to master the playstyle of medium tanks. With this tank, it's really beginner friendly because we got some armor, so you will be not directly punished for your mistake if you don't play correctly with the medium tank. And yeah, for a skilled player who knows the game, having this tank, that means you will be just OP and you will really win a lot of battles, and this tank will really help you to grind definitely your win rate. I played till now 11 battles with the 64% of win rate, and I think this win rate will stay stable like this or even better, because this tank is really worth it to go for it, and if you know how to drive it, you will get really a high win rate playing with this vehicle. That's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I hope I could help you with this video to have a better idea about this tank, and to know how to play with it. I wish you all a good luck to win this tank from this luxury lounge event right now, because in my opinion, it's really worth it, and it's really a very good tier 6 medium tank, and it's even OP in the right hands, in the hands of skilled players who know to get the maximum of potential of this vehicle. See you soon, guys. Bye bye.